Jody?
Okay, I've got some concerns here, and I think I'll just read it. When I joined the South County Planning Commission last year, I was thrilled to volunteer my services to help our county and our community. It has been an eye-opener and rewarding experience, and unfortunately, a troubling one as well. I've enjoyed working with my fellow members on the Planning Commission and enjoyed their good company. However, as I have served, we have all borne witness to a problem that has only become more apparent with each month that we serve. That problem, as I will discuss, is that our chairman has repeatedly demonstrated her inability to run our meetings in accordance with Georgia law, and more critically, she has eroded the ethical line that must be drawn between us and the developers. In fact, our chairperson's ethical line has eroded to the point where she has voted on matters where she was legally required to recuse and then reaped enormous personal financial benefit in return. I present this evidence with a heavy heart and with even more latent concern that I have only seen the beginning of a pattern that is unraveling before our eyes. Despite her 14-year tenure on this commission, our chairman has continued a pattern of violating Open Meetings Act, exposing each member of this body to potential civil liability, criminal liability, investigation by the Georgia Attorney General's office, as well as calling into question the validity of any actions taken by the Forsyth County Commission as a result of our recommendations. Pre-meeting meetings of selected members of this body are a blatant violation of the Open Meetings Act and run roughshod over the ideal of open government. More troubling, this pattern of illegal behavior has repeatedly occurred. Finally, and most critically, the chairman's impartiality is no longer redeemable after a series of votes by her on matters involving Riverbrook Capital Partners, LLC. By the chairman's own admission, she has received compensation from this now defunct and bankrupt developer. Yet, in violation of our rules, she has voted on well over a dozen matters involving Riverbrook without recusing as required by law. But more, even on the three few matters for which she did recuse herself involving Riverbrook, because in fact she received compensation in the form of at least a tennis court and a gate, the minutes of our meetings reflect that she actually and remarkably voted on some of these very matters. The recusals were not even done properly under the law, being devoid of the required conflict of interest affidavit in our minutes, and without satisfying the other recusal requirements under the county and state laws. To this day, our chairperson has remained mum over the value of the compensation she has received from the defunct developer she endorsed in her motions and votes. In addition, the chairman's property tax records indicate that the box to be checked if there's a tennis court on the property is not checked. These shady dealings with a developer have garnered negative publicity in the statewide media outlets and harsh criticism from statewide ethics groups. This body must change course. To maintain the credibility of this body and indeed the South County Commission itself, changes must be made. Period.
Does anybody else want to comment?